Say no to drugs and to carbon tax voting in Oregon. They are both bad for you. Our world is in crisis. Floods, drought, global warming, glaciers almost gone, the San Joaquin Valley drought, California and Oregon simply trashed. Other areas are flooding. We're in drought. We need to stop burning fossil fuel, but not a tax at the pump. The creation of the Oregon State Carbon Tax Bureau would be an expensive nightmare. People all around in the Bureau with their hands on the money getting rich. Nothing really good to say about a 15 cent to 30 cent tax per gallon on gas to slow down gas usage. The poor could not afford it, the rich would not care, and the exemptions would be government, military, airlines, any public transportation, and on and on. That doesn't make any sense. Truckers paying a carbon tax would increase his costs, and you will pay more for everything you have in your home because a truck delivered it. Groceries go up, bus passes go up, everything from hardware to medicine, prices go up. A lot of people don't remember, but in 1973 had gas rationing, standing in line for gas, prices went up, people were driving Eldorados, big Fords, Dodges, Chevys, Chryslers, station wagons galore, big V8s, 420 cubic inch engines getting 12 miles to the gallon. Then the Datsun B210, up to 49 miles per gallon on the highway. VW, Toyota, and Honda slithered in, making a killing. Goodbye, big V8 engines. Then, today, people forgot. Back to the huge SUVs and forgot the price of gas. Just keep driving. Don't tax at the pump. Require all vehicles in the United States to have a minimum 40 miles per gallon by 2030. And so the United States complies and has laws. Well, what about Japan, China, and India? Or we could do what Sweden does and use bicycles as a major transportation, and that really works. But not for the lazy American culture. They just don't care. No to carbon tax, yes to common sense. I'm Bill Kiefer. Until next time.
First up in the news, will more than 5 billion people be killed in a post-industrial collapse of civilization? That's what some researchers are saying, echoing the propaganda from the Club of Rome dating back to 1972 and a computer model compiled by MIT researchers as part of the same project. It was covered in the SHTF plan blog and many other publications. It's based around Australian physicist Graham Turner, who's written on the subject, and my article is up at Infowars.com. Researchers claim only global government can save humanity, echoing MIT Club of Rome model for collapse. And indeed, it is at the heart behind all the rhetoric about global government. They're predicting that human consumption patterns, population growth, as well as energy consumption, will all drive a peak point at which society will crumble and fall, and many, many people will die as a result. The only problem is they admit that it's all about world government. Unlimited economic growth, they say, is still possible if world governments enact policies and invest in green technologies that help limit the expansion of our ecological footprint. Of course, it would not be unlimited economic growth under that model. It would be a containment of the economy. It's all about Mari Strong's Agenda 21, a post-industrial civilization. They want to clamp down on humanity, not empower us. Not to say that population or our use of energy couldn't be a problem, but we're talking about the elites driving the issue back since the days of Robert Malthus, who then predicted in the late 1700s that the population would outgrow the food supply. It was actually just a way to start cracking down on people through early eugenics models.
Shall I do? Hallelujah. The question is peculiar. I'd give a lot of dough if only I could know the answer to my question. Is it yes or is it no? Does your chewing gum lose its flavor on the bedpost overnight? If your mother says don't chew it, do you swallow it in spite? Can you catch it on your tonsils? Can you heave it left and right? Does your chewing gum lose its flavor on the bedpost? It comes a blushing bride, the groom is by her side. Up to the altar, just as steady as Gibraltar, while the groom has got the ring, and it's such a pretty thing. But as he slips it on her finger, the choir begins to sing. Does your chewing gum lose its flavor on the bedpost overnight? If your mother said don't chew it, do you swallow it in spite? Can you catch it on your tonsils? Can you hear it left and right? Let your chewing gum lose its flavor on the bedpost overnight. Now the nation rises one to send their honored sons up to the White House. Yeah, the nation's only White House to voice their discontent unto the president. Upon the burning question, what has swept this continent? If tin whistles are made of tin, what do they make foghorns out of?
Boom, boom!
Does your chewing gum lose its flavor on the bedpost overnight? If your mother says don't chew it, do you swallow it in spite? Can you catch it on your tonsils? Can you hear it left and right? Does your chewing gum lose its flavor on the bedpost overnight? On the bedpost overnight!
Oh, there's a love you're in the one to hold you tight!
A Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday night on the bedpost. The chorus, but he hasn't got the time. On the bedpost overnight.
It's home to Israelis and Arabs. It's home to the Vietnamese. It's home to the Aboriginal people and the farmers of the Australian outback. It's home to the people of Japan. It's home to the peoples of the Caribbean. It's home to all of us, and it's our only home.